guys.
Hello, how you doing?
I always love following Aaron.
So, what can you describe as a tone for season two? Because, you know, like, Gotham City itself, you know, is always going to be dark and only get darker. But, like, what, how is the show going to be, like, in the second season in terms of tone? Like, you know, what kind of goal does it have?
I would say that season one of the show is huge. Well, a lot of it is in your first season of the show, you're trying to find the show. And it was a bit more of like a case of the week to a degree, and we started becoming more serialized as the show went on. And season two, the show would be fully serialized, so it would not be any case of the weeks at all. It'd be like watching the saga of these characters' lives on like one long season, basically story that we follow through. So it'd become much more kind of character specific and less like solving any particular cases. And I think there's also the element in season one, when you watch season one, Gotham, our conception of them was it was a city dominated by like the Falcones and the Maronis and the mob world that we kind of lived in. And season two, we'll see the underworld shift and we'll make that evolutionary shift towards like the beginnings of the world of supervillains and like where do they come from, and then setting the stage for what happens later.
When we ended with the Batcave, finding it's like, will can
it might
tease
have been
us?
A wine cellar. I don't know.
Like, can you tease any of what might be down there, those wonderful toys you might have down there?
Yeah, you know, when they go down into that underground compartment, you know, Bruce will uncover what his father was up to before his death. And it'll be part of an investigation which will give him clues, mostly to his father's death, but also then what was going on inside this kind of like mystery slash cabal inside Wayne Industries. And it'll also let him kind of revisit his idea of who his dad actually was, which will then change his vision of who he's going to become going forward, and giving him an integral piece of what becomes the persona of Batman. So.
Can you give a little...
And he finds, like, you know, like, knickknacks.
Giant penny.
Yeah, exactly.
Can you give a little tease for Tigress, the intro that we'll receive for her?
Yeah, she comes in. She is the sister. She and Theo... She's the sister of a guy named Theo Galadan. So the two of them come together as a brother and sister villain team at the very beginning. And Tigress is... she's a bit demented is the wrong word, vicious, I would say, and homicidal. And she is going to kind of function in a way as a proto-Catwoman, in the way she moves and her weapons of choice. And a young Selina Kyle will see her, and you'll see her like starting to put together the pieces that will then later go, Selina will go, oh, I like that whip. I think I might want something like that. And you see her start to use that to go forward.
What time period is the show technically set in? Because you see cell phones and all that, but it has
It's not specific?
Everyone's asking me, ask that.
Yeah, I know. We deliberately made it non-specific, so you couldn't tie it to anyone. Because we wanted it to be our world, but not our world, you know? And if we didn't tie it to a particular time or place, it gives you just that small fissure with reality where you can bring in things that have an elevated reality because it's not tethered to any time or place.
Okay.
So we try to like...
So it's your own time?
We try to confuse everybody? Yeah, it's our own time.
Well, you're succeeding.
It's Gotham time.
Okay.
Awesome. I was wondering if we could go back to talk about the serialized format of the show.
Yeah.
Something I've noticed in the later half of season one was that you started having like multiple arcs. You know, you had a few episodes, you had Milo Ventimiglia, for example. So is that kind of like the type of serialization you're going with? Or are you going to go with, you know, here's your big bad for all 22 episodes? Or are you going with, you know, well, here's 5 episodes of said villain, then here's 4 episodes of that villain, and so on and so on?
We're going to be the big bad shape. There will be a season long bad guy. So he's not really a bad guy, he's misunderstood. A season long misunderstood.
So it's a he, we know that.
Yeah, right. But within that, we will have blocks. Like, you know, kind of like a 2 or 3 episode arc.
Yeah.
Because it's like when you used to watch like Buffy, you know, like in Buffy, like the mayor would be the big bad for season 3. But even within that, you would have like an episode where she was doing something else, but the mayor's saga story was always pushing forward. Throughout.
There's always someone connected, like, even though if the big bad isn't there, then they may play a threat or two.
Exactly.
Somewhere.
That's the kind of shape we're looking at. So.
sorry.
Are there any parts of Manhattan you haven't gotten to play with yet that you're looking forward to?
That's a good question. Yes, absolutely. I mean, we've shot in all five boroughs at this point, you know. But there are so many great places, and we've never shot in the sewers in Manhattan, okay. Which I think it's you know, logistically incredibly difficult to do that and very expensive. The Strain, I feel like, has some sewer sets that they use that they have not let us use. But if we could shoot in there, I think that'd be really cool. There's some great old like graveyards that would be great in. Yeah. I'd love to shoot in the
cloisters.
Yeah.
So.
I work in a bar. If you need a bar, let me know. Let me know.
We'll hook it up. There, yeah.
Yeah, I mean, no, there's all the great old
history
there.
And...
Yeah. Yeah, great. Absolutely. So the Highline, honestly, is like a little bit too nice.
That's true.
It's dropping. It's.
Are you coming? They're pulling me away.
Is Montoya and Allen coming back at all for season 2?
We don't have plans to yet, but we'd like to see them again.
Okay.
Yeah.